Okay, I think we can get started. So I'm Riku Valtasola from Futurize, and I really would like to thank you all for coming to this session. I really wasn't expecting this huge audience, as this is a kind of partner talk. So I'm a bit worried that I put a too great title for the thing, but let's see what you are expecting. So content what I'm going to talk today is like mostly about, let's say, Futurize and some example projects we have made, and then like a couple of thoughts about why is it so cool to develop for Windows Phone and how we actually do it. It will not be a technical talk, so this is anyway. I'm a manager. I'm heading our Tampere side, a business director at Futurize, so I will be focusing mostly on like quite high-level things, but there is some insight from our developers and things like that in the presentation. So that's my position. Also, check me out from Twitter. I really like to be followed in Twitter, so okay, let's get started. So first of all, a couple of words about what is Futurize. Currently we have four sites. I'm from Tampere. You might hear it from my bad English. Okay, then we have Helsinki site. That's the main site with 100 persons there. Tampere is basically 21 now. Berlin is 20 persons as well, and rest of it is in London. It's a new thing in London, and just ramping up now. There is 5 persons there right now. 115 total, founded in 2000, so existed now for 12 years about. We have won a lot of nice small awards in the past, Deloitte Technology Fast Awards, Great Place to Work Awards, and especially I would like to promote this Great Place to Work Award we won this year. So we were number one in the general series, so best place to work in Finland, and let's say Windows Phone plays a role in that. Nice platform to develop applications for. Okay, and this really means that we really care about our developers, like you can expect, that it's really fun to work with us. Okay, hey, I would like to briefly introduce you to what we are actually doing. So basically, I probably need to stand here because I don't have a wired mic, so let's just talk from here. But basically, our offering starts from like consulting, training services. In there, we'll, for example, design digital strategies for companies. It can be a consumer brand. Typically, it's a consumer brand. Can be also business-to-business brand, but typically, it's a consumer brand. For example, Kesko has been our customer. So there we start like thinking like how this brand should like come to the digital world, what they need to do, websites, mobile apps, mobile web services, whatever they need to do there. Then we have training business. We have, for example, our training business leader, Michael Samarin, here in the front row giving. So he will be giving a talk at 4 o'clock about imaging stuff for Windows Phone. Then, like, of course, it includes some kind of early concepting, this kind of things, this consultancy phase, consultancy and training. Then we have rapid prototyping services. For example, if you want to pilot, like, what is the real technology choice for your service? Should you go to HTML5 or should you build native applications to different mobile platforms or whatever? We do this kind of really fast prototyping services for like demonstration purposes, technology validation. Then, of course, the most of our money comes from this design and development services. We build services and applications from scratch, from scratch basically. So basically, you can buy a fully blown service or application and ship it to the store. That's basically it. Can include back-end services and different mobile platforms, for example, or it can be a consumer web page. For example, Kiinteistömaailma's latest web page is our made by us basically. Okay, then one angle is building like real like IT services that are great to use, like bringing consumer great user experience to the IT services, making like user interfaces and mobilization of IT services with great user experience. There's a lot of people who have been, for example, using this unholy SIP interfaces for work, putting their travel bills there in the systems. We build like interfaces to that kind of systems with really like great user experience. That's one of our angles. Then, of course, we offer also like futurized task forces who take a responsibility of some part of the customer system if we are talking about large-scale systems. Usually our projects are pretty small, so if there is like, a, let's say 10 persons is absolutely maximum usually for our project. So usually the project teams are from, let's say, 2 to 5 persons working. Let's say then the project can be like from 2 to 6 months typically. That's typical. Sometimes the project is 3 weeks. That's also like typical mobile application. If you, for example, need to ship something fast to the Mobile World Congress or something like that, they always call us that you have 3 weeks. Thanks. So what's the actual key offering to, let's say, this audience, what we are actually doing? I probably said most of the things, so I'm not focusing so much on these, but let's say the enterprise mobilization is one of the key angles in addition to things I already mentioned, that really like it can be storage systems or some field work enablers. That's a really like a big growing business, and there is work for many years for a lot of the people in this room also, I believe. So really that this is really like growing place. There is always like there is a market for consumer applications, of course, but this consumer application space is of course let's say smaller money, and there is like less of these applications, or there's a lot of these applications, but you know they are quite small and usually made by application developers themselves, like small companies. For us, there is a couple of nice references on this, and we really want to do this. But let's say, I believe the biggest market for Windows Phone and let's say Windows 8 tablets and things like this for like, let's say, enterprises and a bit bigger companies like us is really in the enterprise market. And I believe the Windows Phone and Windows 8 have really huge potential to this. If I talk about Windows 8, I especially mean the tablet angle, like mobile products there. Okay, I think that's about the service. Just a couple of words how we actually operate, and this can be also linked to the part how. So we work with small and efficient teams, like I already mentioned, that at maximum 10 persons. Typically it's like less than 5 persons in one application development team, for example. If we are talking about Windows Phone applications, let's say it can be graphics designer, project manager who is working, both are working part-time in the project. With graphic designer is also, let's say, UX generalist, then 2 developers, for example. Even 1 developer can be enough, you often. Then we usually work close to customers. We work here with Finnish customers, with European customers, like you saw our sites. Some projects are to the US, but usually we don't operate, let's say, we don't really work with, for example, Asian customers, as we don't have the local presence there. We are focusing on Europe, to the markets where we have the local presence. We really believe that small, efficient team close to the customer is usually the most efficient way to do things, and especially if you are not like talking about the big system like some huge ERP. I understand that these kind of systems you need to like outsource them to, let's say, to get really the benefit from like a huge amount of developers, and you get the cost efficiency and so on. But like, let's say when the size of the development is pretty small, this is the most efficient way to work in my opinion. Then of course modern ways of doing, we are not like we of course work with agile methods, Scrum, Kanban, whatever makes sense in the project, but let's say Futurize is heavily focused on delivering and really caring about the customer, not really on only the methodologies or being like real like heavily promoting doing certain agile methods in every particular project, but let's say we always basically work on with agile methods in the projects. Then of course like one angle is short lead times. I like I mentioned that okay, there's 3 weeks to do a project to MVC. That's a real case I had in my team a couple of weeks ago. MVC was a couple of weeks ago if I remember correctly. Really like to get the project running fast, to ramp up the project fast, show the results to the customer as early as possible. Make the first demos within 1 week or maximum 2 weeks from the start of the project. That's the way we how we work. then like one key angle is also that we have the designers and developers under the same roof. Futurize is not a design company, not a engineering company. We are like a combination of both. We create like applications and services, so we represent basically both sides. Basically, this means that we have about, let's say, 15% of the staff is designers. If I say like 70% of the staff is developers, so 15% is about designers. So this is basically the amount you need, amount of designers you need compared to the developers currently. Let's say the Windows Phone platform is the most productive in our opinion, and there you maybe need more designers compared to the developers sometimes, but usually you really need much more developers. Okay, consumer grade user experience is really the angle to the enterprise market, like I already mentioned. Let's say we are here as a Nokia's consultancy and training partner, so big thanks to Nokia for inviting us here, and real like this is the key technology stack we have been using for years, the Nokia technologies, and also being in the Microsoft camp for several years already. Now, latest focus has been, of course, in the Windows Phone. We do a little bit of desktop development, let's say web development also on these technologies, but definitely Windows Phone is the primary angle, and now in the future definitely Windows 8, especially from the tablet angle, but why not also desktop as the environment is the same now. So to this, our angle is that basically we are now very skilled with the Metro UI. Now Metro comes to Windows 8, to everything. That's now the way to go, and we already have the great skills there, and people are already working on first Windows 8 projects now, so it's really like a cool direction to go. Then also, we are cross-platform development house, so you might see that, well, some of you might see that I have a Apple computer here and like kind of proud of it also. So we really develop for iPhone, Android, even BlackBerry in Finland. Not so many companies develop of BlackBerry in Finland. We are very, very well aware of the open source frameworks, especially on the backend and mobile web development, for example. So we really know also what is the competition and how it is to develop for Windows Phone and Android, for example. And let's say a couple of brands we have worked with. I'm not going to this, as there is so much time, just like showing this Formula One or NASCAR slide or whatever you call it. Lots of logos, operators, media houses, some, let's say, startups, some car manufacturers, things like this here. Both enterprise market and consumer market. Let's say growing segments are like enterprises, banking, these kind of segments. Then a couple of slides about the key thing why you all are here. This is a bit like thin in my opinion, but let's see. So basically, I've talked about this a little already, but I really believe that like this platform, Windows Phone in general, and upcoming Windows 8 also, they really have the potential to being the top choice for business. This is really natural as Microsoft, like let's say Outlook and like the Office package and even Dynamics is nowadays pretty big. When you like think about the competition also, they are really kind of de facto in the industry. So this really has like a good potential to be adopted as the industry or enterprise phone and enterprise tablet platform, especially in Europe and especially in Finland. So there is a lot of potential for these enterprise applications in there. And of course then like Nokia and Microsoft cooperation in general makes this as a, they are really pushing this, and these are so big companies that it's really like creating the third ecosystem or whatever new ecosystem for consumer applications already. So there's a lot of space there also. It's a new thing. There isn't so much legacy, for example, that it's in the competitive platforms. It's a really good place to work there also and get your application now shown. Like it's so difficult to get to those top lists in Apple, for example, in the App Store, but now in this platform it's really still possible. Okay. And then again, like, I think the platform is good. This is, I've heard this mostly from my developers, so I'm not like just like trying to tell that I would develop myself, but like there's a lot of this platform is really like good because it's been built from scratch. It's really clean platform to develop things, and you get really like well, you don't have the fragmentation, for example, you have in Android. It's so easy to kind of ship the applications currently to this platform, at least currently. I don't know about the future if there will be fragmentation, but currently it's really like easy to just like test the applications and get them to the store and ship them. And in general, the application architecture or the platform architecture, it allows really like good performance, as there isn't so like as there is so big limitations, for example, in the multitasking. So it really like makes sure that your application runs smoothly as long as you are somehow like a professional developer. Because in other platforms, sometimes you really don't know what kind of a share of the CPU you actually get for your application. Then like the Windows Phone development is really like it tends to be quicker than on any other application platform we are like using currently. A couple of words about that. So basically the tools are just, they are on par or they are beyond other platforms. This is what my developers who are working also on Android, iPhone and let's say traditional Java-based or Nokia platforms are telling me. The tools are the best available. Visual Studio is really a mature like development environment. The emulator is also very good, and just the on-device debugging really works from box. It really works and makes the development easy. Then again, the documentation is really on excellent level. The MSDN library and in general, you also find a lot of like developer material, especially of course from Silverlight, but also from Windows Phone side. And of course, like it plays a huge deal that the C# and Silverlight in general are really like easy languages, and it's fun to develop with those. That plays also a big role, of course. Then like some thoughts about how. So basically, no matter how easy it is and how quick it is to develop those. And no matter if you have old or new application, you really should do the design from scratch. The Metro UI is so different compared to the other ones. I agree that there are some games where you really want to go with the full custom UI and have the same look on different platforms. But let's say if we talk about any business application, for example, or some other, let's say, social media application or so, you usually should really like redesign the UI completely and do it with skill and love. Basically, this means that, for example, skilled designers like us really do the like our designers, for example, they have really like spent some time going to courses, Microsoft courses and things like that, really like understand how the Metro UI really works and how you should do the application design. Okay. Then of course like also the coding task, there isn't really like reusability possibilities of code from other mobile platforms. You cannot have currently, at least you cannot have, for example, a native library there. You might be using, for example, we have applications on iPhone, Android, Symbian, which are basically using the same native library like C library. This is not now possible on this platform. You have to recode the whole application basically. Then of course, like it's one, let's say, downside to this is that the sandbox is still pretty small in a way that like it's really clean platform. You get the great performance and it's really like nice to develop. You get the results fast and you rarely go wrong, except you might go wrong in the user experience design. And there's a lot of examples in the marketplace for bad user experience designs. I'm not going to show them now, but there's a lot of those we talk about a lot. That's where you can go wrong, but usually you get the great performance, pretty clean application, pretty fast, but like you cannot do all the great features you might be able to do on some legacy platform like Symbian or maybe on Android. it's still like sandboxed. That's the downside, that it's sandboxed. Any comments? Not right now. Okay, then we are moving to the final part, and I have nice time of 8 minutes, so there is a couple of references. I have only put 4 references here. These are business to business, business to consumer, local and global, Microsoft and Nokia ecosystem focus. We do a lot of things, but I haven't really included iPhone references here, except maybe one. But first of all, this is an enterprise mobilization case. Like I said, that this is one of the key angles we are currently working, and where I believe there's a lot of business in the future, also in Finland, Europe, US, in any of the Western world, and of course in the Asia also in the future. We are doing a early distribution service for Itella, so basically like early distribution of Helsingin Sanomat. This is a mobilization of that process. Includes some like back-end integration and mobile clients by us. It's been told that this is the biggest field mobilization project in Finland. Then maybe one of the interesting projects is this Helsingin Sanomat mobile application. You can find it pre-installed from the Lumia. Okay, this shows some other platforms also, but if we are talking about the Windows phone, you can find it from the Nokia Lumia 800 as pre-installed. There is also Ilta-Sanomat made by us. That's another nice example. And there's a couple of our guys at the Nokia booth there. There's a small futurized booth inside the Nokia area, and the guys are demonstrating these applications. So if you don't have a Windows phone device yet, go ahead and take a look at these nice newspaper applications, and especially take a look at this one. I think this is the, let's say, greatest and nicest of the consumer user references, consumer space references. It's a VRC Rally application, and let's say the key use case is that you can really see the cars live when there's a race ongoing. So if you go to Jyväskylä Suurajat next year, you can like use this app and see where the cars are going live while the race is there, and you never miss the cars. You can see from the app that who is coming next to where you are watching, and things like this. Of course, it's a really comprehensive application with a lot of data from the drivers and rallies and teams and you know, all the scores and stuff like that. But I think the key coolness is definitely the live tracking of the cars. Yeah, currently it's using the GPS, I have heard in this one, but there would be also a lot of telemetry available, but maybe in the future versions if there's nice use for that. Okay, then still one on the international angle. This is in Chinese, just like making an example of a mobile application which has like both business to business and business to consumer use cases. This is a product authentication scanner. It's also being used for authenticating like or checking out people's IDs and high school diplomas and things like that in China. So you can work for European customers, and European customers may have like let's say their target market may be in China. For example, this case it is in that way, so we are not really working with anyone in China. We have just a European customer who we have made this for. Basically, it's a barcode scanner, and then also on other platforms, it's an NFC scanner. Let's hope that there will be NFC in the future for Windows Phone as well. So you can check for different 2D, 1D data matrix and so on, the barcodes, and check out then from their backend system. For example, if it's in a product scanning mode, you can check from the backend that is this authentic Nike shoes, or is this medicine actually authentic, or is this a fake medicine package? This kind of consumer use cases for the same application, just a different variant of the application. These are the, let's say, 4 example references I would like to raise from these. I don't have any Windows 8 references I could share with you right now, but I assure you we are already working on nice things there also. Okay, any questions? There. I would say no. Yeah. No, we haven't used that. Well, okay. First comment from me is that we have also been working a lot with Qt, and we have used Qt for Android, but not Momo for Android. Michael can comment more.
When you have certain amount of developers in the company, we came to interesting conclusion that part of being cross-platform means also making as much as possible with the native toolkit that's specific for the platform. And when you have a company of smaller size and you have to push your products forward, the difficult part, of course, you're trying to minimize the development that you're using for different platforms.
Yeah.
And the Mono, it's being for the past, I don't know, almost 10 years, is for anything related to .NET pretty great. But the trick here that in the end, you have to ask yourself, what are you trying to do? Are you trying to save your time and your money in terms of development to target multiple platforms? Or are you trying to get the best user experience?
Yeah, and that's like being the best place to work in Finland also. One of the key things for developers is learning new. That's the, let's say, primary motivator of our guys. So bringing up a new platform to the game is always a cool challenge for the developers. So that also like is a one point for going, let's say, native on all platforms.
And the latest point about that, lifetime and life cycle of the mobile apps nowadays is so short, and when you have very skilled developers, for them, jumping and switching between different platforms is not an issue.
Yeah.
That's just true.
Yeah. Any other questions or comments? Yeah, there.
What is the share of Windows Mobile development and utilized compared to Android and iPhone development, and how do you expect that share to develop in the future?
That's a good question. I currently would say that it's about on par with Qt. We are quite a lot developing also still with Qt, and I think Android and iPhone are a bit behind of that. So that's, and I believe it will be the most like used platform, especially because of this like strong, like, well, Nokia is strong in Finland and Europe, especially in Finland, and there is a strong push into this platform, like I said, and I believe this will be the top platform for us. But I don't know how big the share will be. I don't think it's like much beyond, well, maybe it can be 40% even in a year or something, but I don't believe it's like consuming the whole bandwidth. So there will be Android, iPhone, competitive things also there, and cross-platform is one of the key reasons why customers come to us, because we can work cross-platform. So I believe those other platforms will also stay there in our package or offering. Yeah, there is one question. Yeah, we have full-time designers, so I'd say like 15% of the whole staff of the company is full-time designers. Yeah, so basically they are, I would say the same angle that the designers also want to learn new things, and there is new guidelines and new platforms, so that's one key to that, and the whole working process is so that the designers work in the same team with the developers. Of course, there is like, let's say, concepting phase and early design phase where the development isn't really starting yet, and the developers are just consulting the designers about technical limitations and platform details so that the designers can immediately design something that is that can be coded for the platform, implemented for the platform. That's one key in the process. Maybe I'm not answering the whole question. Yes, yeah, but of course it's not like every person has full understanding of every platform, definitely no. They have focus areas. For example, one designer might be best in Android and iPhone, the other one might be best in Windows Phone and Qt, so there are of course like personal differences, and same for developers of course, so everyone doesn't know everything, but there is like still many persons who know this Metro UI well. So that's just enough. Okay, I think we are out of time, so great thanks to all of you for coming to this session.